cocktail connoisseurs. Presentation is just as important as flavour. In Kenya, one female mixologist is shaking up the bartending industry.
After I went into the bar, I just fell in love with the bar. It was like, this is just the place that I want to be. Just the place you go into and you're like, I want to be here like every day. I want to work here.
There's much more to crafting a cocktail than most taste buds can tell.
Martini, shake it or stir?
Stirred.
Orange or lemon?
Orange.
Plastic or twist?
Twist.
I'm Joan Samia. I'm from Nairobi, Kenya. I'm the head bartender at Art Cafe Coffee and Bakery.
I used to work at Onami. I was employed as a waitress. I used to admire how the guys used to work at the bar and all that. So I asked, can I join the bar? And they're like, no, you know what, one, I think you're too short and all that. But I'm like, no, give me a chance. I wanted to show I can be as good as the guys. So I pushed myself. After the 6 months, yeah, I would say I was good enough as per my boss now to work in the bar. And yeah, I never looked back since then. That was 7 years ago.
Since then, Samia has won several awards, including the Diageo Reserve World Class Kenya Bartender of the Year Award in 2016.
This is a golden shaker. This is the trophy that I won after I won the competition here in Kenya. This is one drink that made me get to the finals. The Kenyan finals for the Diageo competition, which led me to being the winner. It's called the Martian. So the Martian has a bullet whiskey, it has coffee, it has yogurt, it has macadamia that has been caramelized.
Her signature drinks come with a special twist. They're inspired by the sights, smells, and sounds of Kenya.
One of the greatest lessons I guess I learned is like, work with what you have. Here in Nairobi, we have fresh fruits, we have herbs. They're like, they grow anywhere. It's for us to appreciate what we have and make it work from there, because that brings your uniqueness. You have an understanding of what's around you. You have an understanding of your audience.
Beyond her patriotic beverages, she draws on films for inspiration.
I'm a movie lover, so most of my cocktails are based on movies. The movie Desperado, which was one of my favorite cocktails that I made during my competition, and it's a Mexican thing. So Mexican, I'll come up with something with what's in Mexico. I'll think tequila. It's Desperado. It's a harsh movie kind of thing. So it needs to be, you know, spicy. That's really what inspires me, because I love watching TV. So I'm like, you know what? And I take this love and mix it with this love, and if it gives me something, then I think I'm good to go.
Today, Samia is all smiles.
This is just how to make a dawa at home. Enjoy.
But she didn't get to where she is today without some trying times.
My daughter, Joanna, she was born with cerebral palsy. It's been a bit of a struggle for me considering my job, plus trying to give her the best that I can, trying to find her better schools. It makes me work even harder, because I'm like, I really want to give her that extra, as much as this is something that I can't change, but I can at least make it better for her. The main reason that I even went to hospitality, it was because of her. When I had Joanna, I was still an actress. So I had like this 1 year of depression kind of thing. So I locked myself up, and a friend of mine came and told me, you need to get out of the house, do something. I was like, what else? I'm not going back to acting. So she told me, you know what, try hospitality. If it doesn't work for you, then you have nothing to lose. In every achievement that I get from my bartending and all that, I always say a little prayer, because it's her that made me go that direction.
It's that determination that landed her a slot in the World Class Bartender of the Year finals in Miami last year.
Representing Kenya, Art Cafe Coffee and Bakery, we have Joan Samia.
Being in this competition, yes, you prepare for it. Yeah, you know, when you're coming from home, you're like, I'm good to go. I can nail this. But it's a 50-50 kind of thing. Like,
You need to show your personality as a bartender and also be a bartender. So it needs to be a blend of the two. You need to have perfect personality and you also need to make good drinks.
My inspiration comes from my country and how the cocktail culture has grown in Kenya.
I am an ambassador for Kenya because I'm here to represent Kenya, and I know the Kenyans who are watching me and they were looking out for me and they were encouraging me. The fact that mixology is new in Kenya, it's really, one, it's interesting, and it's like I want to be part of this revolution, because right now so many cocktail bars or cocktail-oriented restaurants are popping up in Nairobi. In all this, the excitement is I want to be part of, you know, what's happening. Most of the bartenders here are working like straight cocktail bars, so it's a bit different, their experience. I can tell that the level that they are at is totally different from where we are at in Nairobi. Even preparing for this competition, for me, I had to think outside the box. I need to think what is happening in the world and not what's happening in Kenya. That was like the farthest distance I've ever traveled. The greatest scare that I had was like, oh, look at me, I'm just coming from Kenya. So I'm like, I think I'm like the underdog in this story. But once I got there, everyone was friendly, and it's like, you know, I think we've known each other like forever. It's like, I think it's a bartender thing or something. Like, you get to relate to people so easily. The biggest highlight, I think, was meeting all these famous bartenders, people I look up to. You could see the passion oozing out of them. I want to drink what they're making, because there's just this thing going on through them that you're like, this person is really loving what they're doing. And that really humbled me. I went to World Class 2016. Okay, cool. And then I relax. No, that doesn't work for me. I still want to learn more. I still feel like I need to be at another level and come back to World Class and, you know, make it to top 6 then, or top 3.